Hey, it's Sarah, and welcome back to my channel. So I just wrapped up testing the Sabrent PS5 heatsink, and I've got to say, if you guys have a PS5, I highly recommend that you guys get this with whatever SSD you're going to get, assuming it doesn't already come with a heatsink. I mean, with the current price point, nothing else beats it. I'll show you guys some results shortly. Also, I've got some good news. I think the heatsink works so well that I'm going to be giving one away. Not just that, I'm also going to be giving away a brand new 1TB SSD from Sabrent. Details of the giveaway will be in a pinned comment down below, so make sure you read that. All right. Okay, now let's check out how I tested this out this past week. So I have here with me right now the best-selling heatsink on Amazon. It's called the MHQ-JRH. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna install this one first, and then we're gonna test it out. And then after that, we're gonna install the Sabrent heatsink and test that out, and we're gonna compare the results. So this here is the temperature probe, which is gonna measure the temperature. So we're gonna place it right here, and then we'll put the thermal pad over it. So this was too thick. Let's use a different probe. I found a thinner one. So I connected a temperature probe to the controller of the SSD, installed the MHQ-JH heatsink over it, and got it ready to run some tests. How did it do? Well, we'll find out in a second. You'll be really impressed with how much better the Sabrent does against this double-sided heatsink. So this heatsink actually isn't that bad. It has a lot of surface area and it's double-sided. But because there's not a lot of air that goes through here, I feel like this would do better in a PC because it's inside and it's covered. So this is the Sabrent heatsink. And what I love about this heatsink in particular is that it's already the cover for your SSD, as like so. Since the Sabrent heatsink doubles as a cover and a heatsink, all that heat from the SSD gets transferred to the heatsink and out of the bay much more efficiently than a normal heatsink. Because when that cover is closed, a lot of heat can build off there, even when the PS5's negative pressure works to help with airflow. So here's a picture from their marketing department that gives a pretty good idea of explaining here. The heat gets transferred from the SSD through the thermal pad to the aluminum heatsink, and then the fresh air flows over the heatsink to help further improve the cooling. In theory, that sounds like a great idea, but how will this thing work in the real world? That's what we want to find out. I installed the heatsink and ran the same exact test that I performed on the MHQ-JRH heatsink. Is that the most random name or what? Anyway, the first test performed is a data transfer test where we move data between the PS5 storage and expansion SSD. Although the testing is not a perfect scientific test, I did make sure to perform each test at the same time of each day for the exact same length with the ambient temperature set the same. And here you can see the drive getting pretty warm, and the Sabrent heatsink outperforms the MHQ-JRH by an average of 6 degrees. From there, we let the PS5 cool down for exactly 1 hour and then measure the average temperature over 1 hour while playing some Horizon Zero Dawn. Again, the Sabrent is the clear winner, averaging 38.6 degrees Celsius compared to 42.3 degrees of the other drive. How about some Dead by Daylight? Over the course of exactly 1 hour, the Sabrent averaged 39.8 degrees versus 37.2 degrees of the other drive. Kena also saw the Sabrent show cooler temperatures, averaging 35.8 degrees against 40.2 degrees. You know, I think I'm seeing a trend here, you guys. I also played some Guardians of the Galaxy, and you guessed it, the Sabrent was cooler again, 39.1 degrees to 42.2 degrees. The final game I tested was really interesting because of how warm the PS5 got. I tested the Matrix Awakens demo, which uses the new Unreal 5 engine, and it looks great. And so the assumption is that it really makes the PS5 work hard and puts it to use. After an hour of testing, that assumption was proved correct, as temperature rose to an average of 43.4 degrees for the Sabrent, but it was still 4 degrees cooler compared to the MHQ JRH. So after seeing that, I was curious to see how hot the drive would get without a heatsink. So the next day, I took out the heatsink and hooked up the probe and fired up the matrix. And wow, look at these temperatures. 4, 5, 58, 59, and of course, it reached 60, and it actually topped off at 62 degrees. So guys, this just shows why you do not install an SSD without a heatsink. Compare that to the Sabrent heatsink, which was over 15 degrees cooler. Guys, just, you know, get the heatsink for the good of your PlayStation. You guys have it. This is my favorite heatsink at the moment. I highly recommend it. Now, Sabrent isn't paying me for this video. This is my unbiased and true opinion on this. And you know, some other heatsinks are bigger and more expensive, but I feel like the Sabrent heatsink hits the sweet spot for price and performance. So yeah, there you guys have it. I hope this video was helpful for you guys, and if it was, give this video a thumbs up, leave a comment down below, and hit that subscribe button because it really does help with my channel. And don't forget to follow me on all my social media sites. And I'll see you guys next time.